It's the Late Late Show.
So now we're moving along nicely. Well, next up, Richie, I think we're... This crowd are looking a bit lethargic, aren't they?
Oh, I think it's time now we had a bit of audience participation.
Yeah, yeah, liven them up a bit. Liven them up.
Exactly, yeah. Little bit of Brendan Shine, maybe. What do you think?
I think so.
Yeah, absolutely.
Might have something for them, would we?
You never know whichever is going to be the best side. That's going to be your side, yeah?
Yeah, and we have the house lights better, we can see them all. But we can't get a good look at them down here at all. Yeah. What are we going to have them do, Richie, now? There's stuff to be won, like, there's stuff to be won.
Yes. Brendan Shine had a hit with this song called County's Meet. Right, and I presume you all know it.
Yeah.
If you don't, you're going to know it. Right, so we'll start with this side. They're all going to sing the chorus.
No, we have
you're only getting one chance at it, so...
It's have to be loud. There's only one hand that's going to win.
Roll it there, Desi.
Come on now. There we go.
Not free, oh, not free. We're the three counties meet. Offer my speed and pass common. As I stroll on the banks, I might ever and meet. They're the memories I never forgot.
Beautiful, beautiful.
Very good, very good.
All right, thank you. Absolutely brilliant.
All right, see. Your side, Laura. Roll it again there, Debbie. That song was actually written by Patsy Farrell up the road here in Raton. And his two daughters were here tonight. Gemma Nolan and Sinead Flood. Oh, you hear it. Very good. And Gemma, your dad had another couple of number one singles with Foster and Brendan Shine as well.
He would have had Christmas Time in Ireland, in the Royal Tavish Road, Willow Green Willow, to name a few.
Brilliant, brilliant. And Sinead, do you remember what we sang about 4 or 5 years ago on The Stars in Your Eyes?
I do well, yes.
Yeah, did you do any singing since?
No, I retired.
That's what you think. I have a little microphone here, Sinead. Why not allow me here for a minute? Well, some voice this morning.
We've been talking about Jackson ever since the fire went.
Absolutely brilliant. Happy parents, honour.
Parishioners. This could be good news, Jimmy, no? Give it up, please, for Mary Donahoe, Jackie Devine, and Tom McLaughlin.
Yeah. We'd have another hour's early as well.
sure you would. Stick it in the bag on the way home. Come here, did you ever emigrate or did you ever go abroad?
I went over to England once, but I didn't see all your work.
Did you go over for a holiday or did you say
no? I went over to my brother, but I didn't like it.
And what did you not think?
Just didn't like it, I'm back to the factory.
You were a homeboy?
Yes.
Ah. And you have two football men there besides you now. You're a big fan of the football, are you?
Oh, yes.
You score, you're such a patch of wood off the match.
Oh, the match is all over near the air, near the kitchen area.
Well?
Yes.
Mark, you thought of for comedy.
Yes.
Did you ever see that man, Jackie Dwayne, there, football?
Yes.
Well, tell us the truth about him.
Jackie is all right, I'm not saying a word. No Jackie at all, yeah.
That's for sure. He was a good one, wasn't he? Sticking to the GEA.
Yeah,
that's
since I was
every day to go to
school.
Yeah. Well, give us a rundown of what you think of the prospects for Mostrim now next year, Ash. The team now, any sign of them to win the Sean Conley Cup?
Well, the only thing
they
really want is a good manager.
Right.
Put them in their place. Mm. To win the cup.
Have you any suggestions for them?
No, I'm not going to go that far now.
You're not giving it off that way, Mary. You're definitely right. Take it on, eh?
You're all
right. Are you enjoying tonight? Is it good?
It was very good, it is.
It's enjoyable, yeah. We're not keeping you too late, are we? There's no bingo tomorrow, you don't know.
Oh, there is bingo tomorrow.
Oh, is there? Better get to the bed so quick. We move on to the man beside you now, Tom McLaughlin. Sorry, do you want to say something else? Yourself, Tom, again, a legend around Edgeworthstown and Longford.
Dad, just before I start, I just want to, you may have noticed Jackie used to be up on the stage here.
Just
very loud. Okay. But you'll be returning a favour to me. Back 60 years ago, I was off from America to get married, and we were playing the Junior Match in Ireland. Jackie was just out of Ireland. And there was this fellow played for Ireland. He wasn't an Ireland man, that was with Diddy Cawley or something like that. He was had a name of a hard man. So he was roughing up Jackie. I said to myself, it's time for me to look after this boy. So I shouted about him very quick, and Jackie had left Jackie alone and after that after the rest of the game. So that time, you looked after the younger fellow. Scotty Reed looked after me when I was starting out to play. If anyone thought it was given to me, he took after me. That was the story of last night, but I just tell you that story first out here. Do you remember that, Jackie?
There's a lot of somebody watching your back. You were never left alone. But again, GEA can be an awful lot to do with your life and your whole through playing, through management, through administration. Talk to us about your involvement with GEA.
Sorry?
Talk to us about your involvement with the GEA.
In New York, is it?
When did you go to New York?
In 1956.
Yeah.
Got involved there. I was living in Brooklyn then, and there was awfully fellas training in Brooklyn. Most of the Irish people were congregated up in the Bronx, up that area, up near Kelly Park, like anybody's awfully lads. And they got me to play with awfully first, and it took me a bit of a good crowd. You know, the only senior men I ever won, I would have been awfully in 57. And, but then later on I played with Longford, won a junior men with Longford, because you were allowed to play junior for your own county, and play senior for another county. But that was it. But, then I came back home and got involved, and I was involved before I left. I was playing all the Allen Rays before I left, but it was no schoolboy football. I never played schoolboy football. We started, the first football we played was minor. There was no schools, there was no juveniles, no under 40s or anything like that. Then I began playing for minor, that's all.
Aye, that's interesting. Nowadays they're starting when they're 6
they're starting at 5 and 6 and 8 year olds, yeah. Maybe they're starting too young, maybe. I don't know.
Tommy has a record within the job that He was part of every success that the Mostrim Club had from the 1960s to the 1990s. And that included three senior championships, senior leagues, under 21s, part of the trainer or a chairman or an official at the club. So it'll never be surpassed because now he can only serve for 5 years. Tommy was secretary, I'd say, and chairman for probably say the last 60 years. You know.
Brilliant, sir.
I was
going to
a lot of young players, the Manor School here, when the secondary school was in the Manor, not a lot of young lads from the parish didn't go to Belgium, went to the Manor School here. They all came along around that period, the Jukes, the Nolans, John Green, Harry Devine, John Hughes, all they came along at that time. And they built up from the 66 junior team to keep moving up and improving themselves until finally they hit the goal at the senior championship in 74. So that was the golden era all the way up to 90 school. So basically we haven't won the senior championship in 27 years.
But
here come again, please God. Everybody knows the science. I mean, when Bullenacca won 4-3 championship in a row, the only junior team when we were winning the senior championship, getting the Harrigan junior team up, and they go down again, and somebody else will come up. Hopefully it's us. So we'd see.
Yeah, and you're so happy about that in the administration level of the county board still, so he's keeping on there. And Kevin, of course, is involved with the ladies here, so the
genius. Kevin's involved with the ladies, and Tommy's involved in the county executive during a number of years.
I suppose this time of year, Christmas counts, just to take away from the GA for a minute. Early memories of Christmas, what was back when you were a young boy?
It was so easy going and harmless. My Christmas Eve used to be my favourite time. We used to come into town, my father used to come into town. Well, we used to walk into town, obviously. And my biggest thrill was watching the buses coming into Brady's, bringing home people from England, Dublin. There used to be at least three buses. Brady's was the bus stop up there. John Brady's used to up there. We used to always see lads coming home from England. Some of them were school pals of ours that had immigrated before that. And coming home, that used to make my Christmas see it all the lads coming home.
And in terms of, waking up on Christmas morning, Santa get home?
There wasn't much Santa Claus anyhow.
No.
It was very harmless.
Yeah,
I'll just tell another story now regarding my trip to America. I came home at 64 for good.
And then you don't know when you're coming home. And you don't know what you're coming home on the boat.
I said, no, it might be all shipping on that.
6 days, no, not getting away from the back of that car.
It used to be a party, but we had a tummy and kept for babies as they were used. They were with us coming home that
day. Lord, thanks a million for coming, Dan.
Okay.
There's no need to introduce you to anybody. I don't think anywhere in Ireland we have to introduce Jackie the Miner, synonymous with London football, of course.
Well, yeah, I suppose from the 60s. Yeah, it was a great time for London for football. The 1960s won the league for the first time and only time, and the Leinster Championship in 68. And they played Kerry in the semi final in 68, lost by 2 points. And that was the nearest we got to an All-Ireland final. But it was a very successful time for the Longford football. Just, we got, it was something like money knocked, and I just got a good group of lads together. And, you know, a good trainer, McKiggins, and we all just gelled together. Now, there were some disappointments along the way as well, but it was, we were very close to an All-Ireland final, I suppose, and that's the thing we regret.
But to get that far is a huge achievement.
It was a huge achievement, yeah, especially beating Galway, who won 3 in a row, 3 All-Irelands in a row. We beat them, we ranked outsiders on the day, and we probably were lucky to win it, but it was great at the time, you know.
And of course, you, like Tom, emigrated to America when you were young.
When I went to London, first, yeah, and that's where I played all my club football. And I was playing for London in the Junior All-Ireland final in Cork in 1965. And there were some people down from Longford at the game. So they told the County Secretary, Matthew Fox, at the time. So he wrote to me to see what I declared for Longford in 66, and which I did.
So that's interesting. So you were seen down in Cork playing for London,
yeah.
And they had to write to you,
yeah.
And wait for a response. You know, it's amazing the way.
There was no mobile phones that time.
No landline.
No, yeah, just a few landlines here and there.
Yeah. And the club in London, what club?
St Mary's. Johnny Lane, he was a local man, and Christy Green. They were involved with them, you know, for years, you know.
And you went to America then, when?
Well, I didn't go to America until 1970. My last game for Longford was against Offaly in Croke Park in 1970. And went to America after that.
And coming from London for a match? Where would you train?
I trained on my own, you know. I used to do a good bit of running.
So talk to us about the day of a championship match, right? You're living in London, you're playing in Pierce Park or wherever. What was your routine?
I come home on normally Saturday evening, you know, and maybe stay with some of the lads in Dublin and then travel down on the Sunday for the game. You know, and go back immediately then and have to be back for work. And Monday morning again, you know.
It was a huge commitment, wasn't it?
Well, it was good. It was young, didn't care, you know, didn't mind.
Yeah, and you bring a picture in your house. Tell us about the picture you have on your wall, the photograph of you in the Rogue Bar. I just think it's a fantastic game with that.
That was Kildare in 1968, I think. And it was a replay, and we won it.
And like Croke Park was full, you know.
Yeah, but that was the old Croke Park.
Yeah.
We played 20 times there, that Longford team. We played 20 times in Croke Park during that 5 or 6 years, you know.
Right. And what that mean in Leinster matches?
We played in 2 Leinster finals, but they used to play Leinster semi-finals there and league matches and all that, you know.
Right, yeah. So they talk about opening up now, but it was more available.
There was more then. Now, you know.
That's interesting.
Yeah.
Do you ever think of writing a book, Jackie?
No.
It's an amazing story, you know, you're such a I remember doing the interview with yourself and Margaret, and they brought some brilliant stories about your life.
Yeah.
I think it'd be a good bestseller.
Yeah, could be some bad things in it too.
Well, no, it's good, it's right. And come here, tell me, the current Mostrim team, we got any advice for them now? A new man coming into that role next year, we don't know who it might be, but what advice would you give the team?
Well, so really, it's up to the players. You know, the manager plays a part, all right, but at the end of the day, it's the players that do it on the field. Mm. Manager can't play. And nowadays, a lot of the players blame the manager for, you know, their displays on the day, you know, but it's not, it's the players that does it.
Yeah.
And that's what it's all about. But the game has changed, you know, so much now since I played it. You know, now it's like basketball on a big pitch, really.
Yeah.
And some players never kick the football, it's all hand passing. So a lot of the tradition, the old players wouldn't, you know, they don't agree with the way the game has gone. You know?
Yeah, it's changed
for a lot of
things.
Maybe
you come back yourself, manager.
Yeah,
weather
my dreams
to me. Money was right, Jackie. If Mary wins the bingo, it's my pay to come back.
That's right,
But it's been a pleasure talking to you, Sri. It's great to be having more time, but it's absolutely brilliant. Mary, Tom, and Jackie. Thank you very much.